I would, yeah. I don't accept that the only way to produce a budget is to do things that are unpalatable, by which he means, I presume, things that are going to hurt ordinary people. I think there is an alternative that doesn't require cuts in public services, that doesn't require hitting the vulnerable, and doesn't require hitting low and middle income earners further.
And that alternative is?
The alternative is to increase the corporate tax take, which is abysmally low.
12.5%?
No, to enforce, first of all, to, as a minimum, to enforce the 12.5% rate. Currently, corporations are not paying 12.5%. They're paying, the ones that are even liable, excuse me, liable for tax are paying about 6.5% on average. But as we've discovered looking at this issue in the Finance Committee in the last few months, there's huge amounts of profits that are being generated by multinational corporations that are registered in this country, but they don't pay any tax here at all because of a tax loophole. And some estimates are suggesting that if they were made simply liable for tax in this country, we could generate as much as 12 billion extra euro.
12 what?
12 billion. That was what.
12 billion.
That's what David McWilliams estimated that in the Sunday Business Post, based on the fact that they themselves have put into the public domain that they're only paying 2.5%.
So you don't have to do anything else, just get the
No, that's just one area, but certainly billions could be raised in that area. And profits have gone up, by the way, of corporations while everybody else has been hammered. We've also proposed a wealth tax.
Have you drafted this out? Is there a specific written proposal on this?
There is, yeah, and we did it last year as well. I have it in front of me.
Right. Is this based on, apart from David McWilliams being the author of this idea?
No, he's not, sorry, David McWilliams is not the author of the idea. We proposed last year an effective corporation tax of 12.5%, and we were the first to raise the fact that their 12.5% was not actually being paid. And we've been arguing this for about the last year. I've been kicking up about it at the Finance Committee, although there's a very sustained attempt to block a proper investigation into the low levels of corporate tax that are being paid by multinationals in this country. But the truth is coming out that multinationals and big corporations have generated huge profits. Even during the midst of the recession, profits that are increasing, and they are paying virtually no tax in
Michael,
some cases.
Michael, is that so?
No, it's not. I mean, what Richard has explained there is, in my view, a gross simplification of what is actually happening at the moment. The effective rate of tax has been examined by the World Bank across a range of jurisdictions. They estimate in Ireland the effective rate of tax paid by companies is 11.9%. The European Commission has examined this issue as well, and they believe it is quite close to 12.5%. There is a corporation tax rate of 25% on non-trading income. I mean, when you throw out figures such as an effective rate of tax of 2%, you're taking that, I assume, from the US Senate committee hearing, and there was one company, Apple, mentioned in particular there. And the only way you can arrive at a figure such as that is if you include profits that are not and could never be taxable in Ireland in arriving at that effective rate. Companies pay 12.5% in Ireland on the profits that are correctly taxable in Ireland, and that is in respect of companies that are tax resident here. I mean, what you're saying is that you could basically treble overnight the yield from corporation tax in Ireland without any consequences, and I don't accept that is the case. Now, there is one issue that I would acknowledge, that there may well be a change, and I don't think that it would necessarily have the drastic negative consequences that some people advocate, and that is the so-called double Irish, where companies are incorporated legally in Ireland but are not tax resident here and may not actually be tax resident anywhere, and they don't pay tax in any jurisdiction on profits such as those. I think it's giving Ireland a bad reputation.
Getting rid of that wouldn't result in any additional revenue.
Probably not, because other countries would step into our shoes. And if you look at the official reports that have been done, Richard, on the effective rate of tax in Luxembourg is a little over 4%. In France, it's about 8%. So it's not as simple as you're presenting.
Look, Vincent, the first thing I want to say about this is there needs to be some serious scrutiny of this by journalists, among others, and by academics. Because, you see, we have these constant back and forward assertions by the political establishment and indeed by ourselves, right? And nobody is actually going and doing.
Right, yeah. 12 billion could be got by by
no, I said one estimate.
And now, apart from, and I asked you, was that based solely on what David McWilliam said? And you seemed to suggest no, it wasn't. There were other bases for that assertion. What are the other bases?
What we have in our document is that, first of all, in terms of the companies that are actually liable for tax, 70 billion was earned in pre-tax profits last year, and 4 billion was paid in tax. That is an effective rate of 6.5%. But in addition to that, there are a whole number of companies, because of the management and control criteria in corporation tax, that pay nothing at all, because they're not considered tax liable here. And we can only estimate how much profits they are generating, and the only estimates we have for that is what those companies themselves stated to the Senate, Senate hearings.
Are they generating those profits in Ireland?
Well, we need that needs to be examined.
So you don't know?
Yeah, hold on, Vincent. We don't know.
Well, if you say it needs to be examined, it suggests you don't know.
Vincent, sorry, I'm a member of the Finance Committee, and I asked at the Finance Committee, put down a motion asking that Google, Facebook and Apple should be brought in to answer questions about how much profits they were making and how they're avoiding
paying
tax.
Right, but I'm asking you now. Yeah,
because we don't know exactly, because they don't.
But therefore,
that's
just the point I just made. So you don't know. So you're making.
We know what they have said, Vincent.
You are offering an alternative budget on the basis of figures you don't know whether they're valid or not.
No, because we are not setting down definitive figures, Vincent, because we are being blocked on getting the information. I have attempted, asked the Finance Committee.
Have you any definitive figures?
Yeah, I just told you. The Department of Finance's figures for those that are liable for tax is that the pre-tax profits are 70 billion and they pay 4 billion in tax.
Yeah,
4 billion.
That is
not 12.5%, that is 6.5%.
Yeah, first of all, they're accounting profits. There is a difference between accounting profits and taxable profits because, as you know, adjustments are made for research and development tax credits, for capital allowances and so forth. The reality is in Ireland that companies are required to pay 12.5% in respect of the profits that are within.
Well, how come they only pay 4 billion out of 70 billion?
Because you're using accounting profits as opposed to taxable profits to arrive at that figure.
Because they get loads of tax write-offs.
The only sure way of increasing your yield from corporate.
They get tax write-offs to send their kids to private schools, for example, is the latest one.
Can I finish the point? The only sure way of increasing your yield from corporation tax in Ireland is to increase the rate. Now, that's a valid political perspective.
But
to say that there are all these profits out there that we're not taxing, that we should be
taxing.
That's
your view, Michael. You know, I don't agree with that.
But do you accept that you're using the accounting profits measurement rather than the taxable profits measurement, that there are certain expenditures which can be deducted before tax comes into play, such as research and development, such as capital costs?
I accept that there are tax breaks which these guys are given in order to write off certain amounts of their profits so that they're not liable to tax. But I don't accept.
Do you think it's tax break? Do you call writing off, for instance, capital expenditures over a period of time, call that a tax break? Do you?
It depends about whether these are legitimate write offs. And there's a whole number, the definition of research and development is problematic. Because all sorts of things can be defined as research and development.
Yeah.
There's write-offs for company cars. There's write-offs for expenses of all sorts. There's write-offs for group losses in companies.
I think the expenses write-offs and the company cars write-offs would be included in the accountable profits, would be taken account earlier on. So that wouldn't come into play.
It does come into play.
Look, Richard has a point. I think, you know, you've asked a lot of questions to the Taoiseach about how heavily they are lobbied by groups in the IFSC, and that's all done in private inside the doors of government buildings. But maybe it's getting a bit granular to be getting too deep into that element of it.